Evening all, Gerald here again to take you through another one of my PTPs, Play the Police, and this go around I'm going to cover off probably one of the Police's signature tracks, Roxanne, probably the one that kind of put them on the map, so to speak. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to break it down section by section and take you through it. And in order to kind of not run the risk of boring you to death, stopping every 5 seconds to, you know, tell you what the chord is, what finger goes where, blah, 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 blah. I'm just going to run through it. I'll just name the chords. But if you are a beginner and you're a little bit mystified as to what those may be, fear not, because if you take a quick sniff around down there, in the show notes, you'll find a nifty little PDF of the chord chart that I've put together. It shows all the chords, all the finger positions, fret positions, etc., etc., etc. So hopefully with a combination of that and this video, hopefully, you'll be well on your way. So as I say, what I'm going to do is I'm going to break it down, and then at the end, I'll play it out against the track so you can see how all the component parts fit together. So we're starting off with a G minor chord played at the 3rd fret. So from the G minor chord, what you're going out, here's, you know, this is just depending on how you want to play this. I know that Andy plays this second chord here as an open D minor chord down here. What I actually tend to like to do myself is to actually go into A sharp major 7, where you're barring there, and you've got your fingers are forming the kind of the triadic form of the D minor there, but I kind of like it because it allows me to, instead of kind of like hopping up from there to the D sharp major 7 chord, it actually just kind of allows me to get a little bit of a slide in there, which sometimes I kind of like doing. So instead of kind of like bopping from there to there, you kind of could just do a nice little slide if you want. Etc, etc, etc. Now this is the bridge. It's basically you've got 4 chords, and the first chord is C minor 7. Down to F sus, up to G sus, and then you have a G7 in there. Now, here's a little tip. There is a kind of a slight difference here in terms of what I've seen a lot of people playing, and it's understandable. I must admit, I kind of missed it myself, and it was only by watching Andy's Hot Licks video where he kind of showed this how to play Roxanne, that a lot of people stay on the G sus for 2 bars. But it actually isn't. There's actually a very, very subtle step down on from this G sus into a G7. So you've basically got 4 on the G sus, and then you just take the 4th finger off, drop your second finger onto the G string there at the 4th fret for 4 downstrokes on G7, so it's... Right, now for the chorus coming out of this G sus, you just do a drop down from C to an A sharp. Now here what you've got to do, you've got to kind of echo what Sting's doing on the bass here with an A to A sharp hammer-on. So what you've got to do down here, and what Andy does, he kind of hammers on and pulls off with the first finger on the A string there to get the A sharp. Then you're coming up to the 6th fret for a D sharp, and it's just one kind of downstroke on that, and then an immediate slide up to the 8th fret there for an F. And again, you can get that flavour by just dropping down one fret and then sliding back in it and on the attack of that downstroke. And it's just straight down into F minor to G minor. So let's play that through. a hold on the two bar hold on the G minor there while Sting's going. And you're just playing two bars of four over the top of that on the G minor. So hopefully while I've still got you, let's just also just take a little bit of time just to very quickly talk about the rhythmical quality of this in terms of what you need to do for that kind of to get that clip staccato feel to it. Basically what you're doing, you kind of got to feel the rhythm in both hands. And if you're a beginner and you may not be too familiar with this, basically what you're doing, you shouldn't be playing obviously with the pressure down on the neck, like. So you've got to get that clip staccato sound. So what you've basically got to do is you've got to kind of synchronize with the downstroke. As soon as the downstroke goes in, you release the pressure on the neck to cut the ringing dead. So you get more of a clipped tone to it. Like that. So as I say, you're kind of doing squeezing on, squeezing off with the left hand there, as I say, in time to that downstroke. So that pretty much does it for all the components for Roxanne. So if you want to just hang on for a bit, I'll play it against the actual track so you can see how all those components come together. So as always, thanks for watching. Take care of yourselves, have fun, and I'll catch you on the next go around.